Welcome back to Let's Code. Today we're talking about particle systems in Bevy, specifically a specific crate called Bevy Hanabi. Now, I think that this is going fine. I'm running in debug mode, so it's a little bit janky. I think this would get cleaned up if I wasn't running it with optimizations or turned off and such like that. But you can see that we've got this little circle of particles that kind of spawns in, and then the little particle elements all spawn on the circle and expand and fade out. And that happens anywhere we do a collision. So we're taking the ball's transform and we are turning that into the location to spawn the particles. And you can see a bunch of them just went off up there, and we're changing the color over time. And that's about it. So today we're going to talk about just implementing this and what it looks like to actually use Bevy Hanabi in a real game. Again, this is going to be just kind of the simple version of it. It's going to be circles. And then in a future video, we will consider doing better looking particles or pick something that works a little bit nicer for this game. So let's start off in the cargo toml. I'm using Bevy 0.8 here. It's a little bit old. It's 0.8.0 instead of 0.1. My Bevy Rapier 2D is a little bit out of date, but it doesn't matter for this. And then Bevy Hanabi is the really relevant crate that just released 0.4. We've turned the default features off or set them to false because we are only looking for the 2D camera. So we turn everything off and then enable the 2D camera rendering inside of the particle system because this is a 2D game and we don't need 3D. So to start off, you do have to add the Hanabi plugin, which comes from Bevy Hanabi. Bevy Hanabi has a prelude, which is right here. So Bevy Hanabi prelude star. We have a couple of preludes sitting at the top here. We've set the radius of the ball or the circle that we are going to spawn particles on. This is completely arbitrary. I just kind of chose something that seemed to work. And then when we spawn a new game, we're going to get the assets database for what's called an effect asset. An effect asset is a struct inside of Bevy Hanabi that we can create to access later to spawn particles. So we've got this effects variable. And you can see us using it right here, effects.add effect asset. So to start off, we create a gradient here, and this gradient is going to be the color that changes over time. So the color is going to start somewhere. So 0 is the start. It's going to end somewhere. 1 is the end. I don't know if we can use like completely arbitrary keys here, but I guess we'll find out in the future. In any case, a VEC4 is RGBA. So we've got values from 0 to 1. So it's a linearized sRGB. And then the alpha channel is the last value. So we go from like a red to a purple. The spawner controls how many times the effect spawns or the particles spawn. So we can choose from a number of different options, including burst, once, rate. And in this case, we are using once. So we spawn 30 particles one time. We then add the effect. So we create an effect asset struct, which also comes from Bevy Hanabi. We give it some arbitrary name. The impact name is the name that the example code that I was looking at used. So I just copied that in here because it is actually, you know, an impact anyway. It's the ball colliding with something. The capacity is how many of these we can have. And we have to pass in the spawner as well. At which point we get into one of the interesting pieces of the 0.4 Hanabi API. So in this case, because we're creating this effect asset, we can specify the initialized state of the particles. So in this case, we're setting up the particles on a circle. We're setting the axis to be the z-axis. So this is 2D, and setting the axis to the z-axis means that we can set x and y positions. Of course, the radius is this ball radius. It's the circle sized. So however big the particles are going to spawn in a circle around the point that we pick. And then we have things like speed and dimension. Dimension's not super interesting to us, but you can also do volume here, but we're going to do surface because we're just kind of putting these on a plane. And this will control, so there's a trait that this struct implements that I assume that we can also implement for our own structs, which is what I intend to do in the future, because I want my particles to be inside of the playing box, like the playing area. So there's a number of different initialized sort of structs that let us place particles in different positions. And then we use .render to specify things like what fields we want to modify. In this case, we are setting the size over the lifetime of the particle to 10. So this is just a constant gradient. So the zero value and the one value have the same value, which is 10. And then we're also using a color modifier over the lifetime, in which case we pass in our gradient. So we start with the red at zero and we end with the purple at one. And then we do have to spawn this bundle in. I'm not sure exactly why we have to spawn this. I'm assuming it's to place the entity into the system, but we spawn a particle effect bundle with the effect that we've created and the spawner that we've also created. So this spawner is responsible for spawning this effect. And then we give it just a name. Down in our ball collisions system, we can then query for this particle effect, which is set up in this particle effect bundle. And we can query for the transform of that particle effect. Note that the transform is something that we are going to be setting, so it needs to be mutable, whereas the position of the actual effect and where it's going to spawn is going to come from the ball, which is why we're also querying the ball up here. So skipping past the logic for how we detect whether there's an actual ball collision happening, we can get the single mutable effect because I happen to know there's only one effect in the system, so I can do effect.singleMute. We get the tuple of the effect, mutable reference to the effect itself, and a mutable reference to the effect transform. We need the effect transform to be mutable so that we can set the translation to the same position that the ball is in when it's contacting something else. And then I also set the Z index to 10 because I was having some, what I thought was Z index layering issues. That still might be Z index layering issues, but TBD on that. And then we take our effect, we get the potential spawner, and we reset it. This maybe spawner will try to spawn the particles on the circle in the initialization phase. And that's actually it. That's how we get the circle particles into our app and spawning whenever we collide with something. So the API here is super interesting. We've got the init on the app. So we create the effect, not the affect. So we give it a name, we give it a capacity, and we give it a spawner. So in this case, it's going to spawn 30 particles once. We give it a struct that defines how to determine what the initialized state of the particles is when we create one. And then every tick we have to render, every frame that we have to render, we can put modifiers in here that will modify the properties of those particles as we see fit. So I feel like this was pretty reasonable. I think that the only thing that I'm having an issue with right now is that the particles don't always render. So you can see them not rendering here. But when it does happen, it is kind of nice. It looks a little bit like fireworks, in my opinion, right now. So I'm not going to leave it like this, I don't think. I think that this is fine, but it doesn't look like a very polished effect. You'll see that I also have the Rapier 2D like debug colliders showing on all the blocks and the playing area and things like that because I was debugging something. But I think that we can get this effect to be significantly more interesting or at least more varied at the least. But I am pretty happy with the way that it works now. I did previously try to use Bevy Hanabi around 0.3, and I wasn't able to get it to do exactly what I wanted it to do. So I'm happy to see that it is, in fact, working for us now. And I hope that you enjoyed this video on Bevy Hanabi and setting up some particles. It was a simple setup today. I'm hoping to take this forward a little bit and create a few more advanced particle effects, but I don't know what I want to do there yet, so I'm leaving that for another video, and I hope you have a great day. As always, you can leave comments in the comments, or questions in the comments, or whatever you want to leave in the comments, and I'll see you next time.